In the last video lecture, we have seen some examples on Fourier series expansion for even and odd function in the interval minus pi to pi. Here, again we will see the examples on Fourier series for even functions in instead of minus pi to pi, minus L to L. Our first example is find the Fourier series expansion for fx is equal to a square minus x square in the interval minus a to a. As I have already told you, where we consider even and odd functions when the interval is minus a to plus a, minus 2 to plus 2, minus pi to plus pi, etc. Otherwise, do not consider for even and odd. And here the interval is minus a to a, and therefore we check whether the given function is even or odd. So for that we find f of minus x, and f of minus x we obtain as a square minus x square, that is again fx, which concludes fx is even function. And for even function we know bn is 0 and a0 and an only we have to find out. So what is a0? A0 is, for even function, a0 is 2 by a integral 0 to a square minus x square dx. Fx is a square minus x square. So after evaluation of this limit, we obtain 4 a square by 3 as the value of a0. Then our next task is to find an. So what is an? An is 2 by a integral 0 to a square minus x square into cos of n pi x by a dx. So an is equal to 2 by a square minus x square sine of n pi x by a into a by n pi minus minus 2x into bracket minus cos of n pi x by a into a square by n square pi square plus minus 2 into minus 2 into minus 2 into minus of sine n pi x divided by a into a cube by n cube pi cube. The limits are 0 and a. So here for this we have used our generalized bipart rule. So we have repeatedly using generalized bipart rule. So I suppose you all are perfect in using this generalized bipart rule. Then if we put the limits a and 0, then finally we will get the value of an as minus 4a square into minus 1 raised to n divided by n square pi square, and bn is 0, that I have already told you, and therefore our required Fourier series will be a0 by 2, that is 2a square by 3, fx is equal to 2a square by 3 minus 4a square by pi square, that we take out as it is a constant independent of n, and in the summation what remains, minus 1 raised to n divided by n square into cos of n pi x by a, 2a square by 3. Then after expansion, that is putting the values of n as 1, 2, 3, etc., we remove this summation and obtain the answer as 2a square by 3 plus 4a square by pi square into bracket 1 upon 1 square cos pi x by a minus 1 upon 2 square cos 2 pi x by a minus plus 1 upon 3 square cos 3 pi x by a minus dot dot dot. So this is our required Fourier series expansion. Example is again very interesting. Find Fourier series for fx is equal to minus sine of pi x by c in the interval minus c to 0 and is equal to sine of pi x by c in the interval 0 and c. So here again we check for our even and odd particularity. So we have f of minus x in minus c0. In minus c0 the function is defined like this. So in this, if you put x is equal to minus x, then you are getting minus sine of pi into minus x by c. But sine of minus is minus sine. This minus and that minus becomes plus. That is equal to sine of pi x by c. But sine of pi x by c, as per the definition of the function, it is fx in the interval 0, c. So if you are getting like this, f of minus x in minus c 0 is equal to f of x in 0, c, then our conclusion for this function is fx is even function. And again, as in the last example, only we have to find a0 and an. So a0 is equal to 2 upon c integral 0 to c fx dx, that is sine pi x by c dx. And after evaluation of this limit, we are getting the value of a0 as 4 by pi. See the details. Next, an is 2 by c integral 0 to c sine of pi x by c cos of n pi x by c dx. So here we use our trigonometric result, that is 2 sine alpha cos beta is equal to sine of alpha plus beta plus sine of alpha minus beta. So by this, 2 upon 2 we have adjusted, 2 upon 2c sine of 1 plus n into pi x by c plus sine of 1 minus n into pi x by c dx. So we integrate this. Integration of sine is minus cos, cos of 1 plus n pi x by c. The coefficient of x is 1 plus n into pi by c. It will be divided. So that will be multiplied as c by 1 plus n pi. I suppose you understood all these things. The value of second integration is again exactly on the same way, minus cos of 1 minus n pi x by c into c upon 1 minus n into pi. The limits are 0 and c. See here, I have expanded this, minus 1 upon c. Here it is c by pi. Here it is also c by pi. So that we take out. And what remains? Cos of pi plus cos n pi. Cos of pi plus n pi divided by 1 plus n divided by 1 plus n plus cos of pi plus n pi 1 minus n. And finally, we are getting the value of this as, here I will correct this, cos of pi plus n pi into c upon pi x So it is correct, 1 plus n, 1 minus n. And finally, we will get the value of an as 2 upon pi into 1 minus n square into bracket minus 1 raised to n plus 1. And if we put these values of a0 and an in our formula fx, we are getting as 2 by pi minus 2 summation n takes values from 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to n plus 1 divided by n square minus 1 cos of n pi x by c. See, here n should not be 1, but if you put the value of an when n is 1, that is a1. A1, if you put a1, n is equal to 1 here, you will get a1, and after evaluation, that will give a1 is 0, and therefore our final answer is like this. Thank you.